What went wrong with the economy in the last financial year? That is the question being asked by opposition leader and former Prime Minister Dr. Kenny Anthony. In his presentation, Dr. Anthony questioned the reasons that economic growth had slumped from 5.02% in 2006 to 0.5% in 2007.
Why is it that an economy that grew in 2006 at 5.5, 5.2, 4.9, these are the figures being bandied around, suddenly decelerated in a matter of months to 0.5? Why are we in this sorry predicament today?
In his budget address, Prime Minister King explained the decline in the economy on the increase in the price of oil and other commodities, especially food on the world market. In addition, King blamed the shortfall in banana revenues as a result of Hurricane Dean and an unnatural growth momentum stimulated by World Cup cricket for the development. The opposition leader ridiculed the projection of a 7% increase in GDP for 2008-2009 in what he described as an anti-investment climate.
The international financial community is in turmoil. Everybody is scared of lending. You have a problem in St. Lucia with liquidity. Demand requirements are heavier than actual cash in the banks.
The former Prime Minister had particular interest in the allocations made to the Ministry of Economic Planning under the management of Osbert Dovey and the Ministry of Communications, Works and Transport, which has the largest allocation. He questioned the vagueness of line items for the planning ministry, insisting that the island cannot afford enormous sums for consultations.
Why are you providing this ministry with this, with all of these consultancy fees when people are suffering? Why is the minister being given all this money for consultancy activities when the elderly in this country need help? We do not need these consultancy studies at this time. And it's deliberately vague to cover a multiplicity of sins. You have to wonder behind which of these items there's a Riley Graham lurking.
For the second time in as many years, the opposition leader was not allowed unlimited time to address the budget. Dr. Anthony had expected the ruling party to allow him at least one extra hour to speak, but that wish was denied. The opposition promised that it would not forget that the government had prevented it from addressing St. Lucians on the estimates. Clinton Reynolds, HTS News, Channel 4.